Last week, I shared with you about my recent experience getting an antibody test. The test is to determine whether you've been exposed to COVID-19 in the past. In January, I really wasn't feeling well, and all my blood work came back negative. So I decided to reach out to my doctor to find out if I should take the test and ask him some common questions that you too may have.
We kind of predicted that it would be just a mad rush. We've really not seen that.
In the last 2 weeks, about 70 people have made their way through the doors of Little Rock Family Practice Clinic to get an antibody test, a number much lower than physician Dr. Kent Covert expected. And he's been just as surprised with the results so far.
We have not had a positive antibody test yet at our clinic.
The difference between the antibody test and the COVID-19 test is that the antibody test will tell you if you've been exposed to the virus in the past, not if you currently have it.
The antibody test, if there is a silver lining, it is way more patient friendly. It's just a blood draw, so there's nothing more invasive than that.
Dr. Covert says the turnaround time for the results is about a day or two, but he urges you to be wary of places that promise faster results.
The ones that they're kind of encouraging us to stay away from, at least from the Arkansas Health Department, are the ones that are these point of care testing. So if somebody says, we can get you an antibody test result in 5 minutes or 10 minutes, those are almost certainly not FDA approved.
So what is the point of getting this test done? Dr. Covert says for some, it's simply peace of mind. But there is research being done to see if patients with antibodies can donate their plasma to help critically ill patients.
Some patients have kind of mounted an early antibody response. Some people, their response is delayed, and some people may not have an antibody response. And so that's why the value of this test is dubious, and that's why it's kind of up in the air, is because we really are flying blind right now until we know more with research.
A popular question is, if you had COVID-19, can you get it again? Dr. Covert says right now there's no straight answer and more research is needed.
Generally speaking, you would say hopefully not, but I don't think anybody is confident enough to say absolutely not.
And Dr. Covert says, just to keep in mind, with any test, there is a chance of false negatives and false positives. I myself ended up testing negative. As far as pricing, it can vary. Typically, they're around $50, but make sure you check with your doctor and your insurance company first. Adam?